Welcome back to Urban Rush, everyone. It is time to talk about refrigeration or not refrigeration.
It is true. You can save yourself a lot of your food and money if you learn what to put where in your kitchen. And joining us now, she is the Queen of Green from the David Suzuki Foundation. Lindsay Coulter is here.
Hi, Lindsay. How are you?
Good.
Rumor has it you have your own website now, too.
After you guys were saying it's so hard to find my stuff on the website, then they said, okay, we'll give
her. Okay, fine. Yes. So what is it? It's Queen of Green?
Queenofgreen.ca or .org. Nice. It'll shoot you to our site where I've got all the recipes and the videos and the little pieces that I've been coming on
Beautiful.
With here.
Okay,
and
we
then
are
some.
Here to learn today, Lindsay, and I have a feeling I've been doing a lot of things wrong.
Yes.
Maybe you can tell us about the whole concept of what we've got going on here.
Sure. What I've brought for you today, so now you may be eating local foods, organic. It's a great time of year right now. Everybody's harvesting everything, but you want to make sure that that stuff lasts in your fridge so that you can actually enjoy it.
We're not your fridge.
How much do people throw away? I mean, it was stunning.
The average family will throw out about $600 a year worth of produce, and so that's about one in four things that you're buying.
And if you imagine that piled up, $600 worth of groceries is a lot.
And it's
not
just
expensive compost.
The money, yeah. So you imagine a head of lettuce, 69 cents, let's say you pay, but imagine the farmer had to go out in the field, he had to, you know, rotate the crops, the water that goes into it, the shipping. That's a lot of resources that you've just thrown out because either you forgot about it or you didn't use it in time, or maybe in this case
and
you're
we have
storing
become
it.
Very flippant in these times of plenty in North America and in Western society.
And so this is about saving money and making less of a footprint.
Let's start here.
Okay.
Refrigerate or not to refrigerate?
These are things you don't need to refrigerate and they'll in fact last longer. Potatoes, winter squash is another example, garlic, red and yellow onions, any onions.
I always thought you were supposed to refrigerate garlic. That's what I've been doing wrong.
Cool, dark place will be best for.
I get a few of those.
Yeah.
Same with potatoes, and a lot of people put those in the drawer in the fridge.
In the fridge,
but not so
don't
much.
Put them in the fridge. And if you see them where they're green, sometimes they've got that green hue. That means they've got too much light, and don't eat them.
Really.
So cool, dark place is the best. For those guys.
I remember opening up cabinets at my parents' house because my mom always used to store the potatoes in
cold room
or something like that. And there'd be like this tentacle of potato coming out and it's sprouted and grown.
And onions.
Onions, the yellows will last a little longer than the reds, but they can stay, again, out of the fridge, which is fine because you don't want your rest of your foods to smell like onion anyway.
So. Absolutely.
These ones, again, you don't want to put these in the refrigerator because these are gas emitters. They emit a ripening agent called ethylene gas.
Now, we think of gas emitters bring certain foods to mind, but
people.
What do you mean by gas emitters? Like, what is this going to do in your fridge?
So even once you've pulled something off a vine and it's been harvested, it's still breathing. So you never want to store anything in a plastic Ziploc bag. That's where it's going to mold, rotten, and spoil.
Oh, yeah.
Because these things are still breathing. So even if you're ready to eat this nectarine, and once it's ripe on your counter, because it hasn't been in the fridge, you don't even want to pull the stem until you're ready to eat it. Definitely don't wash anything until you're ready to eat it.
Really?
So these all ripen, they don't have to be in low light or anything?
These can be out on your counter if you're ready to eat them. If this avocado was darker and it's now ripe and ready to go and you're not going to use it for another day, then you can pop it in the fridge for that day to hold it over. Yeah.
Tomatoes, I never would have imagined because I always put these in the fridge, but what happens when you do refrigerate them?
These are very cold sensitive. Tomatoes are cold sensitive. They'll go grainy and mushy and not taste like anything.
So it takes away the flavor, the texture, everything.
That's right.
And
ruins them, essentially.
A huge part of why people are buying organic and buying local and seasonal and all those things is to get all those flavors and then just destroy it.
Yeah, pay the most for your dollars.
Now, what is in this lovely bowl?
So these ones, like I said, you don't even want to wash anything. I've just sliced these so I didn't have to carry the whole melon down here.
But you
these
are
melons,
getting lazy.
I know. And apples, again, these are gas emitters as well, but these can go in the fridge. But you don't want to store these guys in the red bowl next to either of these gas emitters. So hence sort of the two design in your fridge,
so
the two drawers.
Why don't we store these? Like what's going to happen if you store them?
They'll rot and spoil and ripen faster than you want.
Really?
If these guys touch each other and
Vegetable drawer and the food drawer. I had no idea about these.
So I don't know if you're like grandmother ever said you wanted to eat, you know, this peach, which is still hard, tomorrow. You put it in a brown paper bag with a ripe banana and that's going to help it ripen.
My grandma used to do that. I thought she was crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go.
So is that two gas emitters working together?
That's
then?
The gas emitter. This one releases more, and the ripe banana is releasing more gas than that one at the time because it's not ripe yet. So it's a ripening agent is the gas.
Really cool.
So you can help. You can speed it up as well as slow it down. So carrots, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, these sorts of things you don't want to put near your gas emitters. And we have the whole chart and the table. You can print off, put it on your fridge on our website.
Very nice
that
on the website.
Fascinating.
I like it.
And you can save yourself some money and stop throwing out all of that food. I never thought, of course, about the farmer, about the water, about everything that
it's
goes
into
it. You
goes
throw
into
it away just a head of lettuce.
It's a long list. And of course, last time, you know, this banana mask, right? Back to your banana mask, reusing it and composting for your compost
or
tea. But ideally,
banana bread.
Banana bread.
That's my first thought when I see an overripe banana.
You don't
banana.
Think mask and making your skin more beautiful?
No, I think I'm going to whip up some banana bread.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thank you so much, Liz.
Thanks, Lizzie.
We're going to take a quick break, and when we return, we're going to keep on the environmental theme. We're going to be talking about a great new book. It's called The Climate Diet. Don't go away.
I noticed nothing in there is quite ready.
No.
You're not laying us your good food.